Firmware version 3 for the Nikon ZF is here, and it brings with it lots of new improvements, some of which we've never seen before and some of which bring it in line with existing Nikon cameras, such as the Z6 III, the new Nikon ZR, the Z8 and the Z9. I'd love to run you through some of the features that I'm most excited about and some of the ones that you might not have found in the menu yet. When using the new film grain feature, you can adjust the intensity and the size of the film grain that's applied to your stills and video. You can adjust the intensity into 6 different steps, and you can also adjust the size in 3 different steps. When you're adjusting the size from small, medium, or large, it means that you are going to produce larger areas of grain in your frame. And the intensity is going to physically adjust the amount of grain that's applied to your image. This will give you complete control over the exact creative intent that you want for your stills and for your video. Because the grain effect is applied in camera, you can't make any adjustments to it after you've either taken your image or recorded your video. So do make sure that you're using the right settings for the effect that you want before you record or before you take the shot. Because the film grain is applied randomly, it will always give you a different look, position, and shape when it's applied to your stills and your video. Meaning that when you develop your RAW file in camera to apply the film grain, you're going to get a different image each time. Film grain can also be combined with picture controls and imaging recipes, meaning you can use an existing picture control that's already tuned to your liking and then add that film grain effect on top of that as well. It's important to keep in mind that film grain is not visible through the rear monitor or the viewfinder, and only can be viewed in post when it's once applied to the image that you take or the video that you've recorded in camera. Firmware version 3 brings with it 2 new shooting grids. We now have a 4x3 grid for stills, and you also have a 9x16 for video when you want to record vertically. And also, when recording videos vertically, that orientation is stored in the metadata of the video, meaning you don't have to rotate the footage yourself when you put it into your editing software you're going to use. A small but very useful improvement for when shooting video as well is how the camera works when controlling ISO. Previously, you had to change ISO using the ISO dial or by having a function button and the command dial. But now you can have ISO just on a command dial itself, meaning you don't have to risk moving the camera and bringing shake into the footage that you're shooting. Firmware version 3 also brings with it the ability to make use of the focus limiter. This focus limiter was a setting we first saw in firmware version 3 for the Z8, and it's a really useful feature, especially if you know the exact ranges that you want your camera to focus between. So this is not only useful for wildlife and sports, but can be used in a number of different scenarios. Any situation where you're using your camera where you have something that's maybe in your foreground that you don't want the camera to focus on, you can use the focus limiter to shift your focus to the background. Or you might be vice versa, you might be shooting the other way around, where you have something that's close and you don't want the camera to jump to the background. So you can specifically pick and choose the range that you want your camera to focus between, and it just gives you way more control, especially with fast moving or with difficult subjects that are in difficult backgrounds and foregrounds. When making use of the high-speed frame capture options, which allows you to shoot the maximum frame rate of 30 frames per second, there's also a new option that's been added that allows you to shoot at 15 frames per second. And this 15 frames per second can also be used with pre-release capture. For those of you who shoot N-Log using the Nikon ZF, firmware version 3 will also make improvements to the view assist. This view assist improvement has been borrowed from the Nikon Z6 III and also from the Nikon ZR. It makes it much more consistent, making sure your exposure looks accurate. The vari-angle screen on the back of the ZF now automatically disables the eye sensor on the back of the camera as well. So once the vari-angle screen is flipped out, the eye sensor next to the viewfinder automatically disables. This is particularly useful if you're shooting quite close to the camera with the screen flipped out, or if you plan on using the camera on a gimbal. A really nice change that we saw previously in the Z6 III's firmware update is that when you are outputting a ZF to an external monitor and you end recording, there's no longer a blackout from the HDMI port, meaning you can get a consistent view from when you start recording to when you end recording and then continue showing the frame afterwards. Firmware version 3 for the Nikon ZF is available to download now.